Even though it's the case that I've been really hard on Bernie Sanders lately, I want to make it clear that I still really love Bernie Sanders. I think that what he did was amazing, and he's the best senator, hands down, in all of Congress, because every other senator, besides Jeff Merkley, they're either spineless or they're sellouts. So I still love Bernie Sanders. I think he's fantastic, but the problem is, you know, he's been doing things that frustrate me. He chose to distance himself from Tim Canova. He's been campaigning for Hillary Clinton, and he really needs to stop doing that. Because look, I get that the main objective in campaigning for her is to defeat Donald Trump, but by doing that, you legitimize these corporatist Democrats, and you make it acceptable for them to run. But had you distanced yourself from Hillary Clinton after you made your initial endorsement, because I get that, but had you chosen not to be a surrogate, that would send a really strong message to the establishment that they don't get to be corrupt and still get support from progressives. So I think that by you actually campaigning for Hillary Clinton, it's really harmful for progressive politics in the United States, and we're never going to get change if the one party that's still relatively viable, the Democratic Party, is going to be just as corrupt and sold out to corporate interests as Republicans. Now, with that being said, Bernie Sanders has done several things as of late that really have made me hopeful. It seems like we're getting that old Bernie Sanders back. So if you can put aside the fact that he's campaigning for Hillary Clinton and look at what he's been doing besides that, I think that you, like myself, would be surprised pleasantly and might actually think we're getting old Bernie back. So first of all, I had Misty Snow on the podcast. She is a progressive Democrat running for the Senate from Utah. And, you know, I asked her, have you been endorsed by Hillary Clinton or our revolution? And she said no. And she wasn't on the list of progressive candidates backed by our revolution. But as of late, Bernie Sanders, after hearing all of our criticism, Misty Snow has now been added to the list of endorsed progressive candidates on our revolution. And also, he's taken a really strong stance against the Dakota Access Pipeline. So has our revolution. They've also been campaigning against the TPP relentlessly. And Bernie Sanders even went to North Dakota to speak out on behalf of protesters and the Standing Rock Sioux tribe.
There are several basic issues that we're discussing today. And number one is the end of the exploitation of Native American people and the respect of Native American rights, period. End of discussion. And the second issue of global consequence is that we understand that the future of energy in this country is not more oil, it is not more pipelines, it is not more carbon emissions, it is the transformation of our energy system away from oil, away from pipelines, and away from carbon. And this is a struggle that impacts every person on this planet, because the debate is over. The scientific community is 100% clear. Climate change is real. It is caused by human activity. And if we don't get our act together, the planet that we will be leaving our children and grandchildren will not be a habitable or a livable planet. We must not allow that to happen.
Senator Bernie Sanders!
And all of you really do have an opportunity to make history. There are 435 members in the U.S. House of Representatives. You are about to elect the most outstanding member, a leader.
That's the Bernie Sanders I love right there. The one that goes around the country just advocating unequivocally for these progressive policies that we care about, or progressive issues that we care about. Now, finally, I told you a couple of weeks ago how Bernie Sanders had renewed his push for a public option after Aetna had decided to bail out of Obamacare, basically screwing over about 10 to 11 million Americans and making them lose health insurance. And he realized, look, if we're not going to get a single payer system, we at least have to push for a public option. And many spineless Democrats, in true spineless Democratic fashion, decided that they didn't want to take this battle because it's just too politically divisive. And they're also bankrolled by the health insurance industry. So Bernie Sanders, however, even though he revealed inadvertently so just how spineless and corrupt Democrats are, he continued to push and push and push. And now Senate Democrats are actually taking up this cause. So they're now vowing to push for the Affordable Care Act to be amended to include a public option. So The Hill explains, Senate Democrats and liberal groups are unveiling a new push to add a public option on Obamacare on Thursday. The effort is led by senators including Chuck Schumer, on track to be the next Democratic leader, and Bernie Sanders, who galvanized liberals in his presidential campaign with a push to go even further and set up a Medicare for All system. Senator Jeff Merkley is spearheading the effort. The other Democratic senators joining the push are Senators Patty Murphy, Dick Durbin, Debbie Stabenow, and Barbara Boxer. We need more competition in the insurance markets, not less, and a public option would help reduce costs and provide consumers with more affordable options when it comes to their health insurance, Schumer said in a statement. Look, is this single-payer healthcare? No, it's not. But if you're not going to have a single-payer healthcare, I've said this before, you at least have to have a public option. It's crucial because these greedy health insurance industries profit when they give us shitty coverage. They don't want to pay for our medical bills. That's why we have such high deductibles and whatnot. We're getting ripped off. So if you're not going to have a single-payer healthcare system, the bottom line is that you at least need a public option. And Chuck Schumer is absolutely right there. Now, this is honestly shocking to me because you have people who I can't stand. We have Chuck Schumer. He's Amy Schumer's cousin, who is the comedian who recently said that people who are critical of Hillary Clinton are, quote, uninformed. And Chuck Schumer is a very centrist conservative Democrat. He voted against the Iran deal. It was a peace deal that stops them from getting nuclear weapons, but knowing that he probably would profit from going to war, or his donors would profit anyways, he chose to vote against the Iran deal. And then we have Barbara Boxer, the individual who was making up lies during the Democratic convention in Arizona, saying that she was afraid for her life after she was antagonizing Bernie Sanders supporters. Even she's on board. So these are people who I dislike, but I will give them credit where credit is due, even if I still really dislike them. I don't know what Bernie Sanders did. I don't know what the hell he did to possibly get these corrupt idiots on board, but for some reason they're doing it. And, you know, I can't help but applaud Bernie Sanders because no one else besides Bernie Sanders could get them to do this. Now, look, let's be objective here. There are still many centrist Democrats who are not willing to fight for this, but for the most part, this initiative, which is spearheaded by one of the most progressive senators, my senator, Jeff Merkley, this is great, and this wouldn't have happened without Bernie Sanders lighting the fire under their asses. So this is what I like right here. This is the Bernie Sanders we all know and love. We need more of this Bernie and less of the Bernie that's campaigning for Hillary Clinton and pretending that she's a progressive and that somehow it's part of the progressive political movement to get Hillary Clinton elected. Not at all. That's part of the neocon movement, and that's evidenced by the fact that war criminals like John Negroponte are really excited about Hillary Clinton becoming the next president because she's very war hawkish. She's a neoconservative. She also advocates for neoliberal economic policies. So I want to see more of this Bernie. I like this a lot. It gives me hope because I felt like there, you know, inexplicably so, Bernie Sanders had chosen to maybe roll over for the establishment. I don't necessarily think he was a sellout, but I think that maybe he was doing what the establishment wanted him to do by being quiet and not campaigning for Tim Canova and going out and campaigning for Hillary Clinton. But I don't want to see that. I want to see this Bernie who stands up and fights for progressive issues. And kudos to Bernie. This is what I like. I love it. It gives me hope.